for us as a Catholic Church, we know it's the Eucharist.
It's what we call the climax, the ultimate expression of who we are as Catholics. Because when we gather around this altar and we celebrate the Mass, our identity is more true and real because the Lord brings us all together as one. Those in heaven, those here on earth, those around the world. And so what I want us tonight to pray for is that simple devotion that we have for the Eucharist, for an understanding of who we receive here on this altar in our presence. And I'll just ask, I see you here and I know that you understand that. But there's so many in the church that do not, so many in this world that are allowing their faith in the Eucharist to be less than, especially during this time of the coronavirus, when our obligation to attend Mass on Sunday is dispensed with. Let's pray for a deeper faith in this true gift that we will have just a few moments before us, the true body and blood of Jesus, soul and divinity. Let's enter into that prayer.
Lord Jesus, with the universal church, indeed, we adore you. With all the angels and the saints, with the Blessed Virgin Mother, with all those around the world who truly believe in the Eucharistic presence, and you have come to be with us. Lord, we believe, but ask that you help our disbelief. You have humbled yourself and left the glory of heaven to come to be present with us in the consecrated host. Lord, help us to truly understand this mystery, so that as we come before you, we might increase in our faith. Lord, when we read the stories in the scriptures, how you walked on water, how you healed the sick, how you gave sight back to the blind, hearing to the deaf, speech to the mute. It's easy for us to see those stories, and we believe. We accept them as fact. Well, Lord, sometimes we struggle with the teaching of the Eucharist. You told us that you would give us your very body and blood and the life-giving bread. And so, Lord, help us to believe just as strongly in those miracles that you provide for us as a church, especially the celebration of the Mass. You give us this gift to strengthen us as your followers within the world, so that we can become more like you. Lord, tonight, as we come before you, help us to see you with eyes of faith. Help us to know you as we present our hearts unto you. Take our heart and let both of our hearts be as one, so that you can be so present to us and that we know that. As we take our leave tonight, others will experience you because of the union we share. Blessed Mother, if there was anyone who understood the identity of Jesus in this world, it was you. For you were told by the announcement of the angel that the Messiah would come through the birth with you as his mother. And so, Blessed Mother, help us to believe in your Son as you did. To always say yes unto him under all circumstances. Help us to see who he truly is for us. When he walked this earth, when he rose from the dead, when he ascended into heaven, and especially now as he remains present to us as a church in the Eucharistic presence. And so, Mary, help us believe as you did as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. And help us to see he who is before us. My friends, come as you are and ask the Lord to open your eyes to who is present before us, so that you might understand more fully this precious gift that we as a Catholic Church have. Let nothing keep you away from the Lord, whatever it might be. Whether it's sin, whether it's doubt, whether it's struggles, difficulties, whatever it is, tonight, unite your heart to his, so that he might show you who he is for you. It's amazing how fast time flies when you're in the presence of the Lord. We do have just a few more minutes left for this hour of adoration. We just ask that we continue to pray that the Lord will help us in our faith, especially in this miracle of the Eucharist. That He'll increase our knowledge and our faith in what we do in the celebration of the Eucharist, and who He is for us as He comes to humble Himself and be present to us totally and fully in His body and His blood, soul and divinity. Continue to pray for us who are gathered, but also for those who do not know and yet they're Catholic. Those who claim to be part of the Church, they don't appreciate this miracle. Maybe because they don't understand it, or they just don't see beyond the surface level. Let's pray for them that they might be strengthened in their faith.
Yes, Lord, that's really all we need. you in our life. And everything's okay. All we really need is you to embrace us. And every other need will be satisfied. So good to be here in your presence. So good to feel your mercy and love just poured abundantly upon us. But help us never to take this gift for granted. Help us never lose the appreciation of your presence within our lives. May it be the top priority. May we treasure you always. So that as we love you, others will see the way we love you and will draw closer unto you. Now, there's so many people hurting in this world, and so we bring them to you now. Help them also to be caught up into your presence so that they might feel the comfort. They might feel the joy that you can provide for them. To see you clearly, Lord, especially in the Eucharistic presence. If I just prepare yourself for the blessing God wants to give you through His Son, Jesus, in the Eucharist. You might want to extend your hands towards Jesus to welcome that embrace and that blessing He has for you. Just allow Him to love on you right now.
Blessed be God in His angels and in His saints.
Blessed be God.